I'm Brett Poirier.
Let's go check out tonight's special.
Tonight we're going back in time to the days of doo-wops and malt shops. At KC's Classic Burger Bar, they're serving up new school flavor with an old school twist. Here at this 50s style burger joint, the walls are lined with classic cars and iconic stars. With a menu as unique as the decor, you can even wash down one of KC's 8 signature burgers with a spiked milkshake. Owned and operated by Katie Cerrone, we had a chance to sit down with her and find out how she brought this American classic into the 21st century.
All right, so we're here at Casey's Classic Burger Bar. We're at the bar, and I'm with Katie Cerrone. Your family is, of course, the Cerrones that is known in this area as a car dealership, but you're here in a restaurant. What was the shifting gears for you?
The shifting gears actually took a long time. I grew up in the car business. I worked for my dad pretty much my whole life. As a kid, started out in the office. The girls would keep me busy numbering the checks in the checkbooks or anything, I guess, to keep me out of trouble. And always thought that I would be a car dealer, to be honest with you. I worked there through summers in my high school, college, even after grad school. I always found myself going back there. The turning point probably came in graduate school, and I was down in Washington, D.C. I realized that I wanted to be home near my family, but it didn't have to be in the car business necessarily. And, you know, grew up in a family business, realized how important that was to me, but more than anything, it was working with people and for people. I love customer service. I love sales. That's what drew me to starting a family business of my own.
This place definitely, we were talking before, definitely a family restaurant. It's great for kids, great for adults, and you actually have a ton of your family members working here. Can you talk a little bit about working with your family?
Working with my family is definitely a blessing and a curse, I think. My cousin Mike is my rock star back there. He's been on since the beginning, works full time. As a cook, he started on Dish. He actually also has his MBA, so he's been super helpful to me, just in running the operational end of it. But he started on Dish, he worked his way over to Fry, now he's on Grill. He's really, you know, a hero back there. My sister Alana works part-time as a waitress. She's actually a Channel 6 reporter down in Providence. My little brother was here helping on Dish when he was home from the University of Michigan this summer. Even my mom has stepped in to help on occasion when we're slammed, and my dad, my marketing genius, you know.
You guys, luckily, you have a big family. You can fill out the whole restaurant.
Yeah, you know, our family, the Cerrones, actually extend to Attleborough, North Attleboro, Providence, where we're all over the place. You can't escape us.
So you're in Maryland, you decide that you want to come back and have a family business. You pick a restaurant, and you come here to North Attleboro. Now, this was a 50s style kind of restaurant before you bought it. Did you want a 50s style restaurant, or did you just kind of find this place and was like, I'm gonna go with it?
This I would call being in the right place at the right time. This opportunity, when I found this diner, it was a 50s Americana themed diner, but it was such a beautiful place that I said, well, I'll keep it, I'll roll with it, and I'll do a 50s classic car themed burger hop. I have so many pictures, old pictures of classic cars, and you know, it's just a tribute to my family.
Yeah, well, it's a great thing that you were able to kind of blend your family business with your own business to come here. So where did you get all the memorabilia though from?
Well, as a matter of fact, I would have been fourth generation car dealer in my family. It started with my great-grandfather down in Providence. My grandfather, he was Al Cerrone Jr. He went by Smokey, and that's his picture up on the wall, actually. So I actually stumbled upon all these pictures in my own house that I was storing some stuff for my father. And I found all these pictures right around the same time I was opening. And I said that it would be perfect. And there's a cool company down in Rhode Island that put that together for me, that wallpaper. The other mural on the far wall, those are all pictures from the Gillette show that they host up at It's through the Mass Cruisers Club, and they put on a huge show up there. And I reached out to them. I said, hey, I'm opening a classic car themed restaurant. Do you think your members would be interested in sending me some pictures? And next thing I know, I open up my email and I have hundreds of pictures. So it's cool. It's cool for local people to come in and see their own car on the wall. Say, hey, that's mine.
That's awesome.
Yeah, it's a good story for people. So.
How long has this been here in North Attleborough?
We've been open for 9 months. We opened in late February.
It seems like so much longer. I feel like you guys have really ingrained yourself in the town, and it's such a cool sign that's out front and stuff. I feel like you guys have been here for such a long time now.
To me, it feels like a day. It's gone by so fast. You know, we're doing what we can. We'd like to be active in the community. I know that goes a long way, especially in North Attleborough. It's such a close-knit town. And I'm fortunate to have the name that I do. My father, you know, has helped me out tremendously. The people at Town Hall are amazing. They've helped me get connected, you know, with important people in the right groups. And, you know, I'm a community type person. That's why I didn't last long down in the city.
Now, you guys, you talked a little bit about your menu. You have a very interesting menu. Where did you get the ideas from for your burgers and for some of your meals that you guys put together?
The burger ideas came mostly from my favorite meals that I cook myself at home, my favorite flavor combinations. For instance, a Blue Hawaii, it has teriyaki sauce and grilled pineapple and roasted pepper on it, on top of the burger. Now, if I'm at home cooking myself dinner in the summer, I skewer chicken and pineapple and peppers, and I baste it in teriyaki sauce and I grill it, and that's my favorite meal. And so I knew, you know, that's the flavors work well together. The Rise and Shine, give credit to my little brother for that. That's our breakfast burger.
Which the Rise and Shine is one of our personal favorites. When we come to try Casey's, we always get the Rise and Shine. That's definitely one of the best.
Yeah.
So credit to your little brother for that.
You're not alone. That is probably our best seller, the Rise and Shine.
It certainly works for me. Now, the other ones you guys have is the Cadillac Burger.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me a little bit about that one.
Again, probably one of my favorite flavor combos is sweet and savory. The bacon jam is homemade. It's like a balsamic reduction. We cook it down with bacon, onion, brown sugar, and it becomes a sweet bacon jelly with the blue cheese crumbles. It melts in your mouth. It's awesome. We put more bacon on it because that is our Cadillac. It has to have the most bacon on it. And we also add American cheese because it helps everything stick together. So
you guys also have the Super Sport, which is a spicy burger you guys offer, but possibly the most interesting burger I've seen is the Elvis Burger. You guys got the fried banana on top with the peanut butter and jelly sauce. Who was responsible for that creation?
Elvis. Elvis was. I gotta
is
give him the credit.
Is that something that he actually would eat that burger?
He did. Well, not in burger form, but he was not famous just for that sandwich, obviously. But he had peanut butter, jelly, and bacon, and banana sandwiches. And he would deep fry the sandwich itself. So we said, you know, we'll give it a shot, give him the theme, instead of frying the whole thing. I said, well, let's just try to fry the banana so that it doesn't look just like a raw banana on your burger. And it ended up being a killer, killer sandwich. It's my favorite one.
Yeah, it's a great sandwich that you guys put together. Now, you don't just offer burgers. You do have a few other crazy ones that you guys put together, and I encourage people to try them out. But you guys also offer some pretty great hot dogs as well, too. You guys have some chili dogs and everything.
Our hot dog is a quarter pound. It's definitely a meal, but we serve it. It's an all-beef hot dog, and we serve it on a brioche bun that we butter and grill. It's the best tasting hot dog I've ever had. To be honest, unbiased. It's a great hot dog to begin with. We make our own chili, and we put a melted cheddar sauce on it, and if you are okay getting your shirt, you know, a little messy and leaving with sticky hands, and you gotta try it.
So we came in actually a little while ago, and you were not kidding. That is a huge hot dog. I was expecting like a little like regular size hot dog. Comes out. It is a quarter pound
giant
hot dog, and then with the chili and the cheese on top, it's definitely a meal for anybody. That's a great, great hot dog.
It is. The funny thing is, you'd be surprised. More older women get that than anyone else.
Really?
Yeah, it's so cute.
Do you think it's because they expect it to be like a dainty hot dog, and then you guys surprise them with something?
It could be. Bam, there it is. You know, you can't take it home. You just make too much of a mess. You end up at the end kind of using a fork and knife with it.
You gotta wimp out at the end.
There's something like a quarter pound hot dog seems so much bigger than a quarter pound hamburger. It's almost more food than our whole half pound hamburger is.
It's too much to handle.
It's good. It's a chili dog. We do it right.
So you seem really excited about the menu. It seems like you're really involved with it. You put a lot of the stuff together. Can you tell me about some of your other food that you guys offer?
Yeah, well, we are proud of our burger menu. I think that's why people come, because they hear burger bar and burgers are super trendy. But we have a few other things, and everything is homemade. That is what we're really proud of. All of our sauces on our burgers, all of our dressings are homemade. Our chicken fingers are homemade, and our onion rings are homemade. And the chicken fingers, outside of the Elvis burger, are probably my favorite menu item. We start from fresh raw chicken, and we buttermilk and flour and fry them to order every single time.
So now you guys offer one of the coolest things I've seen is the spiked milkshakes. And that's where we kind of take this restaurant from a family bar to an adult bar. The spiked milkshakes, who came up with the idea to spike a milkshake, and what kind of drives that?
That was partially trial and error in late nights working on our menu. And when you're tired and you've been sampling all day working on a menu to try to open a restaurant, you say, what if I didn't put milk and instead I put booze? And that's what's really, I think, the beginning of what might be making us most popular in the area, the spiked shakes. But the possibilities are endless. You have so many different varieties of flavored vodkas and liqueurs. A lot of the creations came from on a martini list. You'd have, this flavor martini. You can easily make that into a milkshake. The same booze and a little vanilla ice cream.
All right, so now it's time for one of my favorite parts of this whole show. What are we having today after the interview?
Well, today we have a little bit of prep work to do, actually. We have to bread some mac and cheese balls. So we're going to take you in, show you how we make one of our appetizers. We're also going to throw a burger on for you, probably the Blue Hawaii today. And we will flour and fry up some onion rings for you.
That sounds great. All right, after this break, we're going in the back. We're cooking up a classic burger, and we're going to have ourselves some mac and cheese balls. Don't go anywhere.
What do North Attleboro residents think of international, national, state, and town issues? Join Peter Gay for Up for Discussion, featuring members of local media, town officials, and people like you. Based on HBO's Real Time with Bill Maher and Hannity on the Fox News Network, Up for Discussion tackles the topics making headlines. Up for Discussion every month on North TV's community and government channels, Comcast channels 15 and 98, and Verizon channels 23 and 24.
Hey food fans, tonight's special is a new show on North TV that brings you, the viewer, behind the scenes of your favorite restaurants here in town. Watch as I try each local spot in town one episode at a time. We talk to the owner, the chef, and even get to try some of the food on the menu. Tune in to tonight's special before your next night out. Tonight's special with host Brett Poirier on North TV's community channel, Comcast 15 and Verizon 24.
All right, so now we're in the back. I'm here with Jason. Jason, how long have you been working here at Casey's?
I've been working there since February when we opened. There's a new restaurant in town, and I've always been interested in cooking, and I wanted to help. Everybody's all a part of something. Like, I cook the burgers. They're over there prepping stuff for the day that we need, and everything all happens right here.
All right, so why wait any longer? Let's put this bad boy together, huh?
And all of our burgers are topped with our homemade burger seasoning.
Is that just a little butter wheel?
Yeah,
it's a butter wheel. I gotta get one of those in my house.
It's pretty cool.
All right, so what kind of burger we have here?
We have the chuck and sirloin patty, and the chuck provides the flavor, and the sirloin makes everything come together, the flavors come together.
You guys certainly don't mess around with the types of burgers you throw down there.
No, we also have grass-fed beef and veggie burgers as well. Turkey burgers. So we got every kind of burger you want. Grass-fed beef is something we started recently to try to get people into like healthy eating, because the grass-fed beef is healthier. There's no, like, it's supposed to be less fat and things like that in it. So we're trying to bring it around to get people to eat the healthy stuff, but you know, burger like that is just as good.
Leaner cows mean leaner people eating the cows, you know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
You guys seem all really creative. Like, if I'm at home and I go to eat something, it's usually just like a PB&J. So what's the inspiration coming from?
It's the idea of putting all different things and making it into a burger. Like, the ordinary things. Like, I came up with a pastrami burger. It's a burger with pastrami on top, Swiss cheese, and fried onion rings. Like, I thought of that because I was eating a sub one day, like pastrami sub, and I was, ooh, I should make that on a burger. So I tried it out, and I liked that.
Does it mean anything for you when someone kind of enjoys one of your creations, and you could say, like, I came up with that idea, it's original, it's mine, I own it, and you loved it?
It makes me feel good, because it's like, you put your thoughts and ideas into something and have somebody to say somebody likes it, makes you kind of feel good, because your ideas worked out together, which you like the flavor combos, they liked it, so it's a good hit for both of us.
What's your favorite part of cooking?
My favorite part of cooking is the end result and tasting everything. And I like to try new things, so when you come up with a new thing and then the end result is good, it makes you feel good. Like, when I came up with the pastrami burger, it wasn't like, I didn't know how well it was gonna sell, I didn't know if people would like it, but we get good feedback on it, people love it, so it's good.
My favorite part of you cooking is the end result too.
Alright, Jason, so we're here on the burgers now there. We got the pineapples on the grill. You got some roasted red peppers that are going on.
We're going to top it with some Swiss cheese.
We're topping it with some Swiss cheese. This is looking good right now.
When it melts all together, it looks even better.
Now, you added just a little bit of water there, or is that just to keep it kind of juicy?
It's more or less for the steam to melt the cheese. The steam melts the cheese over it.
You know, one thing I'm learning as I do this show more and more is ways to melt cheese. It's astounding, the different ways people melt cheese.
And we also have these burger hats that you put over the burger and it helps keep the steam in and melt everything nice together.
So what are we grabbing here? We got some lettuce, tomato, onions.
Teriyaki sauce goes on top of the bun.
Top that off. That is a good looking burger right there. Let's get to those onion rings, shall we? Now this here is the boom boom sauce.
Homemade boom boom sauce.
Food up!
Stay hungry, friends. We'll be right back.
If you're interested in local government and want to know more about how it operates here in the town of North Attleborough, then North TV's government channel is what you need to watch. North TV televises all meetings of all the town boards, committees, and councils. That's North TV's government channel, Comcast Channel 98, and Verizon Channel 23. North TV, bringing the community and town government into your home.
How much do you know about North Attleborough town government? Whether the answer is very little or a great deal, Inside Town Government helps you learn more about your government, town departments, services, and more. Join me, Jared Ware, as I sit down each month with representatives from town departments, Inside Town Government on North TV's community and government channels, Comcast Channel 15 and 98, and Verizon Channels 23 and 24. North TV, bringing the community and town government into your home.
Today, Eric Almirola behind the wheel in that 43 car.
We all have a role to play here at Richard Petty Motorsports. We respect each other, work hard, and that helped us get the big win in Daytona. My partners in the U.S. Air Force also know that it takes a team to make each mission a success. Your coworkers, family, and friends are your team. Treat them with respect, and together you can accomplish great things. This message is brought to you by the U.S. Air Force.
A promise was made. A promise that hit the beaches of Normandy. A covenant that split the skies over Berlin. A vow that captured Iwo Jima. A promise was made. A solemn oath that liberated Seoul. A sacred trust that defended Kaesong. A pact that dug in Da Nang. A contract that weathered Tet. A promise was made. A pledge that stormed the desert in Iraq. A bond that patrolled door to door in Fallujah. An IOU that braved IEDs in Kandahar. A promise was made to America's veterans. A promise we all must keep. DAV fights for all veterans and their families so they get the health care, financial benefits, and support they earned. If you're a veteran who needs help or you'd like to help us keep the promise, visit DAV.org.
So I moved down the line over here. I'm with Katie's cousin, Mike. He's busy at work. He's making one of their special appetizers, something to go along with your meals here at Casey's, is the mac and cheese balls. From what I hear, this is one of your favorites.
I love it. They're so good because they're great on their own, but they're also great on top of a burger. And our kind of new thing we've been doing since we added a homemade marinara with our meatball and chicken parm, dipping them in marinara is kind of catching on.
Tell me a little bit about what you're doing with the whole process of making these.
Yeah, it's pretty much a three-step process. We cook the pasta off on the stove, nice, a little bit al dente. We mix it together with three types of cheese, our cheddar sauce, mozzarella, and then we dice up American very finely. And then we spice it up a little bit, salt and pepper, a little garlic, onion powder in a bowl, mix it up thoroughly. Then we have to cool it down for about an hour in the fridge. From there, now we're at step three, which is breading them. A little seasoned flour, then we have the egg wash, and panko breadcrumbs. And then last but not least, pack it together.
And now it never seems to be enough. You guys always need more of these. This is one of the favorites here.
Exactly. I always, you know, at first I was telling Chef Jason, because he always likes to be overprepared. And I'm telling him, we don't need that many. Why are we breading five trays? He said, trust me, we're going to need them. And then, you know, by the end of the weekend, sure enough, we only have two orders left and we got to go right back to square one. People are crazy about them and, you know, I love them myself. So I stand by my product.
We'll be right back with more Tonight Special. Why are you so successful so far?
If you love local sports, then SportView is the show for you. Watch as I, your host Brett Poirier, show you the ins and outs and X's and O's of your favorite teams. You'll get an inside look of what makes the Red Rocketeers so successful.
That it's their responsibility as upperclassmen in our program to teach those younger kids.
Learn about player personalities.
While you're running your mile.
Oh, a lot of times it's Uptown Funk.
And what drives North Bryan.
When I was little and coming to the games in town, it's the guys that I wanted to be, you know. I came to the games looking at all those guys. They were like heroes to me.
They're really hauling off on you right now.
Yeah, I know. It's too easy.
From high school to youth, fall, winter, and spring, we cover it all. SportView on North TV's community channel, Comcast 15 and Verizon 24.
Decision 2016 North Attleboro and the start of election season is upon us. Are you interested in engaging in civic duty with the Board of Selectmen, Board of Health, or School Committee? Three-year seats are available with the Selectmen, Assessors, Electric Commission, Board of Health, Public Works, Park Commission, Planning Board, School Committee, and Library Trustees. Take out your papers from the election office in Town Hall by December 18th and return them by December 22nd with 25 signatures of North Attleboro residents and start your campaign for office. North TV, bringing the community and town government into your home.
Katie, as much as I love talking to you guys, I think we could be here all day. This is my favorite part, is we finally get to eat some of this creations that you guys have put in front of us. We have Mike's favorite mozzarella balls, and we picked none other but your favorite burger. We have the Blue Hawaii here. You came up with this yourself. This is something that you've tried. I'm excited to dig into this. You guys match that with the onion rings, and of course, you told me that I have to try one of your spiked milkshakes.
You can't come in without trying one of our shakes. And if you don't feel like the booze, we have awesome non-alcoholic ones, but you gotta make it worth your visit.
If you're of age, you gotta grab one of these. That's tonight's special, everybody. One of my favorite episodes so far. Katie, you can't let me drink alone.
Well, you don't have to ask me twice.